Hi everybody, it's Carlene again, Pink Scrapper, and I just am starting my second video on The Melting Pot by Ranger Inc. and Suze Weinberg, and I wanted to show you the difference. Okay, this is a single flower with a bling covered with UTEE, and that looks cute. And then here's one covered with UTEE, and my big finger's in the way. Okay, and it just has a little flower that's not covered, oops, and a little bling, and I haven't glued these down, so they're flipping all over. So that one's cute. And then this is the leaf that I covered, and these are three layers. This looks really pretty. And then this is two layers of flowers, both covered with UTEE. So you're gonna have to just play with it and see which way you like it. Okay, so today Suze did a video on how to make a little medallion using the clear UTEE, and that's the only one I have right now, so that's what I'm going to use. It does come in different colors too. So what I did was I have one of these tag maker rings, and I only had circles, and so I put this on a wood block, and you can use an unmounted stamp as well. And so I just put this over where I wanted the image, or what image I wanted. And then I'm going to take the melting pot, and then I'm going to drizzle it into that ring and let it sit. Now, you don't have to do anything to the actual stamp because it's rubber, so it's not going to hurt it. And then you want to just tilt it back when it's full and let it drip. Okay, and it might have, you know, a little string like your glue gun does, but you can just push it back in there and make sure you don't use your finger because this is hot. Okay, so now Suze says you have to let that sit for 5 minutes. So I'm going to let that sit, and we're going to do something else. But this is actually how it came out because I tested it before. Okay, so this is how it came out. My ring didn't stick on there for some reason, so I'm going to have to glue that down. And it picked up some of the black that it was stays on, I think, that still was on the stamp. That's really cute. And then I covered the back with some perfect pearls, and I think this is the copper. Anyways, I just took a little brush and just covered the back. And that's how it came out. So I'm just gonna have to glue that back on, so it sticks on there. But super cute embellishment. Okay, so now the next thing I want to show you is you can actually make tiles with this. And this is a candy mold, rectangle candy mold. It's not very deep, and I bought it a long time ago. That's the beauty of doing a lot of different crafts, is you have a lot of different stuff laying around your house. So what I did was I kind of eyeballed the middle of it, and I cut out some little squares or rectangles, the shape of the middle, and I'm going to put it. I couldn't decide if I liked it up, facing up, or facing down, so I put both of them in there. And this is actually the butterflies from the Mariposa set. Let me move this over and hopefully you can see. Now these are small, so I'm going to have to be very careful because I don't want the UTEE to just come pouring out. So you just kind of drizzle it, and then I'm going to move it over to the next tile and keep going. And these, because mine are so shallow, it took less than 5 minutes to dry. The other thing is that I ended up cutting the shape down to a more detailed square. So if you want to do that, you can still cut the UTEE after it's formed. It has to be warm though, and your scissors will cut right through it. Okay, so I've got a little dribble. And the other thing is when you're done, you just turn off your melting pot and then put the cover back on. Let me move it back. And then it doesn't waste your UTEE. So, okay, so I'm going to put this aside and I'll show you how it turned out. Okay, so here's my cute little blocks. And I'll hold them up for you. I did, like I said, I did cut it. I'm really bad at bringing it up to the camera, but it's really, really cute. It's probably not going to take a good image. So that one was with the paper right on the top. And then this one is with the paper on the bottom. And then the clear UTEE is, you can see, there's the paper. And there's the UTEE. That one came out really cute too. The only thing is, the one that you have with the paper on top, you can also take your perfect pearls, this is copper again, and just cover the top of it. And it actually goes on the sides and it gives it a really glittery finished look. I'll rub that. Okay, and again, you probably can't see very good detail because they're so tiny. I'm gonna have to get a bigger mold, I think, but they're super cute. You can adhere it to, whatever you like. I thought about putting it in a flower. Like that. I thought it was cute. Put it on the side as an embellishment. Okay, let's see if this one's dry. Okay, see it just peeled right off. Oh, it's so pretty. Okay, this one, I must not have filled it enough because this one is in there. So let me cover it with some perfect pearls. Pretty. Okay, so let's see if you can see that. This is the butterfly, the middle of the butterfly. So, anyways, I'm really pleased with that. Let's see if it looks good in a flower. Wow. Oops. Very cute. Okay, ladies. So that's it for today. I hope you liked both my series on the melting pot and the UTEE. So you can have fun making your flowers and making other embellishments. This is what I do. I keep a little bag handy. And so when I'm doing my mini books, I have my flowers ready. And I take it into sections. So I do the flowers first and just have them on hand, and then I don't have to worry about dragging everything out. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, just let me know. Thanks, bye.